September 11, 2020. Here we are in my garden. I took all these inside because there was a little bit of a frost for a couple of days. But my Tabasco's popping. We got my chocolate Trinidad scorpion. It's the main one that's usually up there. Let's say all the things. What do we got here? This is the Foodorama Scotch Bonnet. There's nothing on there. Get that out of the way. MOA Scotch Bonnet. There's nothing on there. None of my flowers have taken. It looks good though. It's nice and happy. It's my habanero. My neighbors are hooting. There's a little tiny one. It'll probably get orange. This in the background is my chocolate Trinidad scorpion. Woo! In the cloth pot, there is several on here. Ooh, that's a good one. This one right here is my Bahamian goat. I'm like, wow, this guy came out at the end of the show. He is going. I did not expect that. Hopefully Mr. Schmee doesn't destroy all my plants while I'm making this video. This and that. What is this one? The Carolina Reaper. Nothing this year. Stay back. Do not do that. He's about to destroy everything. This is my Taj Mahal Pink Minion. Let's see if we can find. There's one of them. I don't know if this is gonna get very much bigger. It's really pretty though. It's totally different. Pretty happy about that. So that's what's going on. Come here, Hank. You want to be in the video? This is a chocolate Trinidad scorpion. It survived supposedly sub-zero temperatures, like close to freezing temperatures. Take a good look here. What do we got? It seems to still like have some flowers. It survived. So here's the lettuce. Mostly fluffed off. I left all this so I can like observe lettuce life. I'm so like surprised. It's totally just like a weed that we got. It's totally just like a weed. I'm so surprised. This is another lettuce. What else we got? These are my carrots. I pulled one of them out for lunch earlier. That wasn't too bad. They're pretty pitiful. Watch. Oh, that is ultra pitiful. We gotta. Most of them are not that pitiful. Only. We gotta find something decent to pull out. I can. Kind of see how big they are down there. There's my finger. Wow, I must have pulled like one of the biggest ones out earlier. There we go, that one isn't too bad. Short and sweet. I'm totally gonna grow some different kinds next year because that is pitiful. Right to me. And my tomatoes are still tomatoing. They're just all flopped over. These are indeterminate, so it's just like it goes until the train wreck at the end of the season. This is like almost been 5 minutes of you looking at weird stuff in my garden and listening to planes go by. This is my Tabasco plant, by the way, right here that I'm looking at. I'm gonna pick a lot of these. This is one of my favorite peppers, just to eat fresh. Here, we'll grab one of these. Maybe this will be a 10-minute video. Oh man. Oh wow. Tabasco peppers are something different. It has so much like juice inside. Eating a fresh pepper is an experience with these Tabascos. Makes you tear up a little bit. Watch this. Hank knows about the spice. Hank. Hey, Hank. Look. Look. He's like, hell no, dude. Yeah, he knows. He still eats my tomatoes, though. Oh, wow. So those Tabascos are like a deep burn. The taste is really good, though. You can tell somebody's like worked with the genetics to refine that taste. Let's see if I can bite this in half and show you. It's juicy, man. I got juice up. Oh, man, and this one is even hotter. These things are pretty hot. They say 80,000. They ain't kidding. Especially, like, I got these seeds from my grandma. I don't know where she got them, but she's like, seriously, like New Orleans Cajun. She knows that stuff. So who knows where these genetics came from? They are mean and very unique. Oh, I dribbled a little bit. See, that's why you don't have to watch me when I do this. This is my lettuce. This is a black seeded Simpson, I do believe. This is the longest video ever of my tiny little garden. And I've eaten two of these Tabasco peppers. Another one of my chocolate Trinidad scorpions. I'm never gonna eat another one of those whole again ever. I know better, but I like them the best on my potatoes in the morning. I don't know, unless this Bahamian goat beats it out. All right, I gotta go. There's